That is my son, and he just turned one. I know he can't have everything, but I do know I will do everything within my power to make sure that he gets the best in life. Every time I leave the house, I have the same question in mind. Have I given enough to him? I have great hopes for him. He'd grow up, go to a good school, get a first-class education, healthcare, everything that would enable him to achieve what I could not. I believe these are ambitions that every parent has for their kid. But I'm lucky. There are those who do not have the same opportunity, who dream for a chance to dream, in the same country, at the same moment, at the same time. Lamu is probably one of the most famous of the coastal towns after Mombasa and Malindi. It is famous for lush hotels, now increasingly replacing the old town lodges, beautiful beaches, historical sites, and donkey races. But beneath everything, there are simple needs. Needs that my family may have, but many here do not.
If you move to the remotest areas, then you will see the suffering these people are going through. Like, you find their mother, there's nowhere she can be referred to, there's nothing that can be done. She bleeds until she dies.
The maternal mortality in Lamu County is estimated to be over 1,000 per 100,000, which is far above the national average, which is 408 women per 100,000.
Even if it's one, then that's really sad, because you can imagine either someone has lost a wife, some child is left without a mother.
Beneath the history and the beauty lies facts that disturbed me. Worldwide, according to the World Health Organization, over 350,000 women and girls die of complications related to pregnancy and childbirth each year. In Kenya, this is about 488 per 100,000 live births. Lamu's average is estimated to be over 1,000 per 100,000 live births. That is why I'm in Lamu. That is why I'm here, to put my head around it and try to understand how this can happen.
With improved technology nowadays, we can communicate. Somebody calls you and tells you there is a patient coming. So this patient has to come by sea. You have to wait. Sometimes you wait the whole night. Sometimes you're told that this patient passed on in the open seas, they had to go back.
Lamu Town is a small town on Lamu Island, which in turn is part of the Lamu Archipelago, and in turn part of Lamu County in Kenya. Essentially, Lamu County is divided into two districts, Lamu East and West, which are further divided into several divisions. Faza, Kizingitini, Kiunga, Amu, Hindi, Mpeketoni, and Witu. Look at it like this.
Population distribution in Lamu is that the majority of the Lamu population live in Amu Division, Mpeketoni Division, and Faza Division. The rest of the other three divisions are very sparsely populated. That is Kiunga, Witu, and Hindi.
The population is sparse. So actually, due to the geographical terrain, transportation is a major problem. Most of these mothers, when they are in labor and they face a hardship maybe in the rural health facility, transporting them to this place is really a big challenge. Yeah, you know that there are no ambulances.
There are dispensary units in almost all those islands. However, the level of service that is provided is inadequate, and they would need to be referred to the higher level of facilities.
We have a very old ambulance which sometimes doesn't even reach where we are going. Like if we want to refer a patient to Malindi or to Mombasa, yeah, it is really difficult.
To put it simply, it takes between 6 to 10 hours to travel from here to the district hospital here by a normal boat. The same distance is covered by a speedboat in 1.5 hours. But that again has a catch.
Bei ya petroli hapa iko high sana. Kama sasa hivi hapa bei ya petroli iko 150 per liter. Iko more expensive than kila mahali kokote. Tunaumia sana. Sasa kwa hivyo bei ikiwa juu na sisi tukifanya kazi na bei tunapandisha.
The boats that do ply between the islands are only on specific times and days. That means that if you have to be transferred from one facility to the next and you are not able to hire your own boat and relying on public transport, you will wait for at least 2 days. But if you come to the, because the boat travels only once a day and it comes back the following day.
Lamu is one of the few areas that do not have a tarmac road, with some areas taking up to 48 hours to access.
On the mainland, there is no formal transport. The culture of matatus are not well developed here. So, for example, on the route to Keunga, there is no single public transport all the week. So people in that region actually rely on lifts from the armed forces.
Now, imagine a pregnant woman who is due, or one who has just given birth, or a newborn baby who has had complications in either of these places. Accessibility is not the only thing that affects maternal and newborn mortality in Lamu.
Those with normal deliveries, after 48 hours, we know we're supposed to discharge them. But in Lamu, most of them prefer going home even after 2 hours post-delivery.
Kuna wengine wanasema mimi nilizalishwa na mother-in-law. Kuna zile saa vile kama cultural huwa wanafanya. Sasa wanapata pengine huwa wanazalishwa na mama ama nani.
Lamu is a conservative society. They want to keep the old traditions over time. And this is reinforced by the religion. For example, the religion does not allow women to be examined by males in health facilities.
Most of the women, they cite that like it's against their culture to go and be delivered by a man in a hospital, and find that the government posting actually does not rely on specific areas to say that we'll only post female nurses in Lamu. Like, so you see, that's one of the challenges, and also the over-reliance on the traditional birth attendants, which we call the TBAs, is also very high among the communities, because mostly find that these traditional birth attendants are women. So the people, most of them, they want to go and deliver there. At least they know these people, they are close in the community. And
from everyone I'd spoken to, I got the sense that there was a deep need for investment in Lamu. But then, what about the structures that already exist?
Sasa outpatient kawaida inaanza na hapa. Hapa ndio mahali wanakuja. This is a waiting room. We normally start with here. Aya, mama wajawazito na watoto wao. Hapa ndio wanapanga line. Wakingoja. Aya. Sasa mahali pa kujifungulia ni hapa, hii room, chumba hichi ndio mahali pa kujifungulia. Ilikuwa hatuna chumba, tumeng'ang'ana tukaomba hichi tukapewa. Lakini shida ni kwamba hichi chumba kinashikana na outpatient hapa, antenatal mothers. Kwa hivyo wengi huona haya ndio kujifungulia hapa. Originally haikujengwa kama ni hospitali. Hii was just a building. It was an office, which was just improvised. Tunataka kuconvert hapa mahali, iwe partitioned, tupate, tuweke taa, haina taa, tutengeze sewage system, manake lazima mtu akijifungua hapa damu itatoka. Sasa tunataka iwe partitioned, tupate mahali pa kina mama kujifungulia. Pengine idadi ya watu itaongezeka, manake kule wanaona aibu. Mchana hawezi kuja bwana, kwa sababu facility hii imejengwa so temporarily. Hakuna staff quarters.
Yes.
Wale wa staff walioko kila mtu yuko kwa?
Kwa.
Sasa mpaka mgonjwa aje tupige simu. Atafutwe yeye kama usiku uje sasa hapa. Tuna delivery bed tu. Mama akishajifungua tu ile uliyoona akimaliza akae kwa bench angoje kwenda nyumbani.
If you look at the infrastructure, for example, if you look at the health facilities, the dispensaries and the health centers, the infrastructure is not developed. For example, some of the dispensaries do not have delivery rooms. I think you saw what they are using as a delivery room. And you see mothers there, they cite the privacy, lack of privacy in that place. Because they are delivering here and other people are just here on the way. Now if a mother is screaming there, when she comes out, everybody is like, oh, this is the one who was making that noise. So you see, they don't want to go and deliver there.
Despite all this, there are various players, groups, organizations that have intervened to solve this problem.
We've tried to create partnerships, especially with most of our partners and through our health stakeholder forums, so that we urge each other, so that in our own small ways, we can see what small way we can play in trying to improve. And we are really seeing, in terms of the partnerships that are being built and the efforts that are being made, in trying to see that we have some improvements in terms of our health indicators.
Our indicators have started changing. People are willing to spend time, people are willing to discuss issues with us related, people had suggestions. We have been able to build some of the community structures that we have planned to do, like setting up community units. We have trained community health workers. We have trained religious leaders.
Kimira chao hawaende hospitali, kuzalia hospitali. Wengi wao wanakaa nyumbani hata clinic hawakuzuri. Lakini sisi kama CHW tunawaelimisha umuhimu wa kwenda hospitali na kupata clinic na chanjo.
Talk much as we might talk of having just at least one professional health worker at a given facilities. Previously there were even facilities that were run by community health workers, but we are seeing an improvement in that.
I would like to think that things in Lamu will get better, but then I was hit by this metaphor. Less than 10 months ago, the National Health Insurance Fund donated an ambulance that would ease the accessibility problems. Right now,
we have a boat ambulance, but then it's not in use because of the fuel costs and fuel implications.
The need therefore falls on all stakeholders to work towards strengthening the already established structures and resources.
The reason why we want to talk with political leadership so that we can develop a healthcare system in a concerted effort with proper plans to be able to improve the health service delivery in the county.
I started this journey with the thought of my son, and hard wish all the mothers and children of this country what I have for my family. Lamu has the foundations to give this to its people, but there's a need to accept both the challenges and the strides made to make things better. This is a thought I live with.